Go online again to Assistant Commissioner of Police, Head of Media for Salon Police, Brahima Kamara. Good morning, Brahima, and welcome to the program. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning.
Yes. As I tell listeners, we tell listeners now one power headline, police don't arrest Alhaji Ahmadu Bah, where people can call LJ after una be done put warrant of arrest for him and ask people that anybody we lead to arrest or show say we say a day, then go get 5 million loans. This morning we get a news say they don't arrest him. You can confirm this to listeners.
Yeah, that is affirmative. We arrested him last night, a little over 1 o'clock in the morning, where the patrol team mounted division, where they up American embassy there, and then go on patrol, and they end up for arrest him, and then hand him over to the CID, who they go answer to the offenses that we, the police investigate them for. So it is confirmed. And I will say affirmative, say we don't arrest them. Then at the police custody.
Before this arrest, the police put a public notice out, say, then they issue warrant of arrest for them. And anybody, we show we say LJ, then they get 5 million loans. We make people be wonder if we be don't invite them, you know, show up, we make una lead or una go this direction.
You know, we get processes when it comes to investigation. Talking about invitation. Now, when you avail yourself, you say that we invite you. But the man was never seen. The man went on the ground. They call him only 9 cents, 9 cents lay down. They say, we should be say that they in the tap, in a Swiss hotel. We go there, the man not there. He was nowhere to be found. So now, only way we don't say, well, I mean, the offense may involve itself. It has to do with public morality. People who get law will tell you, say, especially philosophy of law, they will tell you, say, certain laws and the way they make them for preserve. The moral values of society. The society not to run society where they just allow somebody just to cost somebody any kind. If not plan, it costs no money. Oh, that it's not cost somebody. It's when the chief cost. So if you say, you know, so cost business, not the way we value in our society, not the way we detest. And at one area, then the way normally people go, where they make law, they say, okay, look at what we call legal moralism. Understand? For say law, make this law because one people preserve the moral values of society. So cost, especially to a female somebody, will not be very frank. I mean, man sometimes get for absorb a lot of things in there, but woman, I mean, especially on the kind words that we use and the kind things that we say, I mean, not be very frank. Nobody not going to do that one day to anybody that you feel happy. And then a public figure, in a public figure, and the first we don't to also a public figure. So they expect to even an artist, they get a very large following, and I mean, if I live by example. If not lead by example, then the law will help you for making lead by example. So this is what we are doing. The law is there for everybody. Now, only when somebody breaches the law and I tell you they come in for say, well, we have to enforce it. That's our job. We enforce, and the judiciary then for interpret, and then the parliament then for make. So say, the parliament make, if parliament don't make her, we know the enforcer. Now, because parliament make her, they enact them to law, that make we the enforcer. And because we enforce her, that will make the judiciary the interpreter. So everybody get a kind of tripartite arrangement within the criminal justice system.
Brahima, so, earlier you talk about forgo answer to the crimes them, and you don't begin mention some of them. For somebody where they listen to you now, we not aware of waiting exactly lead to the warrant of arrest or the arrest. What exactly leads to this?
We have offense with the court, public insult and provocation. We also get offense where they call threatening language. We then include them, call them threatening remarks. But now, at the criminal norm, at the criminal coinage, but the actual legal coinage are threatening language. Where you threaten somebody, say, you go hammer, so on and so forth. Or you insult somebody publicly, where it will be to the annoyance of every other person. You know, and when you look at this one, you will find out this large wrongful statement. So many people wrongful to that attention. People are annoyed about what happened. So the elements and those fit in very neatly. You understand? So public insults and provocation, we're also talking about threatening language. So those are the offenses we are looking at. And then we want to make sure, say, we give them fair investigation. But we need them for like an answer to the one. And then we could not see them. We'll not get them. We try for law, get them. We're not able. We don't go alternative fast, we do it, we do so. Now, that's one of the processes we involve when it comes to investigation. You put out warrant of arrest, and then you also declare the person wanted. And then he is also to look for getting. He was declared wanted yesterday, And today, we don't get the man. So, I mean, I think we achieve what we want.
So what's next after the arrest?
He has to face the investigation. We get for answer to the allegations away the against them. And then after which, that will be determined afterwards. Because within the powers of the police, you get the power for arrest, you get the power for stash, you get the power for detain, you get the power for investigate, and then we get the power for prosecute. These are all powers we then give to the police. So at various times and then in between, we use them. Now the arrest in Oregon will be. Now he's now being detained, and then we are moving on to investigation. And then we will also get for move on to prosecution at some point. So that's the situation.
Away from the issue of LJ, Assistant Commissioner of Police, there is also an issue of journalists being beaten by the police, an alleged allegation now. We involve Central Police them. How far police don't go with this investigation?
Fair enough. Yesterday, when we get to press conference, we... the IGP Joseph attend, you know, we all see where the IG can, and as chief executive, we talk to the press. I mean, we know they shield them from the press. We talk to the press. We also make reference to the fact that, yes, we don't see AYV, Thick and young Voices, Media Empire. They complain, say, to a press release, one of them, a journalist, Buna Central Police Station, and then see them manhandle them. So we see that press release. They don't talk to you directly, but indirectly they talk to you, because when they come out to the press release and then you see the call on the police management to make the act. So we see them, we're all in social media. So we say for the self act. We also come out to the press release, where the management come out to the press release, where they say, we don't hear you to say, and then we say the call for investigation, because you will see. For at any time somebody feel aggrieved or offended, you get the right for going to police. You get the right for the police as an institution created by the Constitution, and they also get a statutory backing under the Police Act of 1964. You know, now we're responsible for people. We delve into those issues, or look into those issues. So whether it concerns police or it concerns any other person, the police get responsibility. So now that makes we say we are going to investigate. And then we even not stop there. We go further for say, let AYV, they avail with that personal. Because we say we don't care for Colin. And somebody who gets personal relationship, we don't care for Colin for no, we know, look at them, but we understand, say, I mean, in the try for get some treatment, which we personally call them AYV as well, tell them, say, well, let them become available to you so that we wait for, we will come for car assist investigation. So we not get somebody with the eye, we not get come back close. Understand, but we just want to make sure say, everybody gets fair investigation, everybody gets fair time for deal with the police. So that matter is under active investigation. We expect say the complainant, we and the AYV staff member, therefore come to me, because yesterday we were able to contact them personally. Apart from the fact that we contact management of AYV, we also contact them personally, because in line to be there on now. So he promised for say we come today, and then see the ID, we'll look into them administratively. And then the other aspect will also be looked into, because if somebody they say he was detained unlawfully, we have to look at it. If somebody say he was assaulted, we also have to look at it as the case may be. So from a two-prong on a two-track approach, we for you to make sure say we just give them justice, because everybody wants justice.
Brian Makamara, what are the punishments of police officers them if we find anyone guilty for attack journalists and beat them?
Not particularly journalists. I mean, if you go particularly talk to journalists, somebody will say, why they specify, say, we journalists do this, we possibly do this to journalists, now this can punishment for that.
Now, because so, that in the case in question,
we're going to call infractions. For any time we get infractions of rules and regulations, we get under the police discipline regulations of 2001, it specify a range of sanctions. And the sanctions are too many. So it depends on the gravity of the offense and how the allegations will come to the court. Then the presiding officer at the end of the day gets a range of punishment where you look and say, well, you will either be dismissed, or you will be demoted in rank, or you will be transferred, or you will be removed from barracks. Or then there are so many. But specifically, you know, we'll say this one for journalists, we do have now this will happen. But you get a range of punishment the way. With sanctions within the police discipline regulations of 2001, where the presiding officer opened to them for make a met out to the possible we call defaulter, because to me, we call them defaulter.
Away from the issue of the AYV journalist we police allegedly beat, let's look at the issue of arrest of Dana Konomani, Kamo Kaba, and Femi Claudius Cole, we been there with now then there. For people where they listen, what's not been the reason, Media One?
Hello?
Yes, I said away from the AYV journalist where police allegedly beat. Let's look at the issue of Femi Claudius Cole, Dana Konomani, and Karamo Kaba, we been there with now then there. What's not been the reason for the arrest?
We already get a national event, census and a national event. And that one was proclaimed by the first gentleman of the Republic, where His Excellency Brigadier General Dr. Julius Madabio, he called for census, where so it don't become a national event, where we expect national participation. So in the event, by the rules and the regulations and by waiting the laws, I mean nobody enough for obstruction, nobody enough for incite anybody for say you know for take part on so on and so forth. So if somebody gonna radio, especially the radio I talk to now. And then you make some comment away. We believe see, this comment away, we get the potential for make a cause of justice, or for make the process be flawed, or for make the process not go on. Then you need to come and can answer. So it has to do with incitement. And incitement, just like incitement, conspiracy, these are all increased offenses. We always get the opportunity for call somebody. They are indictable anyway. You get somebody for get the opportunity for call somebody and come or can list the young side, and then the police will make a determination whether the element may they constitute the offense, they are okay, and if they are okay, then we have the options now, we have the indication to charge or not to charge. But to be calling come because the statement there and the utterance they make, you see they get the potential for disrupt the whole process, of this census way and midterm census. So they were brought in for incitement.
Brought in for incitement, but before this time, we don't see position from different political parties, them, even the political head, them, we don't see a position from them. Somebody where they listen now go say, instead of going after the members, for don't like target the head way, there be the pulling release here.
Probably, I don't know whether are you station noise or what, but I'm not getting this last question very clearly.
The question are that we look at them people away they under question now or we will not be arrested but don't grant them bail belong to a political party and that not the position of the young party itself. We now the APC and also the UP and we come together and form COP. They all belong to them party they are so. Considering the fact that they are in the political position where they don't pull and they go by the dictate of within the political party where they belong to see. Why not the political party head than then supporters or the followers?
The political party, my entity, my individuals that make the political party. And the rule says every man is responsible for the natural and probably the consequences of his or own act. You may talk about definitely not for target because I carry life. Now we will talk to you.
Okay, thank you very much, Assistant Commissioner of Police, Brahima Kamara, for Talk to Radio Democracy this morning.